coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State and TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. This crowd excited to see their Jaguars as both teams emerged from their tunnels a moment ago. We are just about ready for football as the Jags get set to match up with the Cleveland Browns. The first 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in week nine? No run back here on the opening kickoff as we'll start at the 25. Down to zero, and this is not the way to start a drive. Offensive penalty has us back where we started as they come up on a first and 10. A shotgun snap and again the ETN. And shedding him off, now open field. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49.
Good, strong, explosive run that started inside, which means you've got to control those defensive linemen, the defensive tackles, the nose guards. Those guys have to be controlled. How about the offensive line, the job they just did?
Yeah, key that A-gap usually on those runs, right?
That's where it all starts because everyone wants to kind of control that area. It disrupts things from the defensive side and the offensive side. As we just saw, it opens up possibilities.
On first down, Lawrence completes it to Davis. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. Give him nine there on the first down completion. This defense for the Browns, they were excellent a week ago in the win over Pittsburgh.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
Looking to throw again on second down. Lawrence flush to his right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
They'll run with ETN. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Yes, yes.
Hey, Alpha.
Lawrence will throw. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here.
Check 13. Check 13.
Looking to throw, Lawrence. They'll get this out to the flat for ETN. Calling a gain of three on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And oh, that nearly an opening drive INT, but it does fall incomplete. Not the way you wanted to start this ball game, as it brings up fourth down. Now a field goal try coming up here for the Jags. This from 54 yards away. And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And the Jaguars grab a 3-0 lead. They were probably hoping to get him a little bit closer for a shorter field goal, but he was able to get it done from deep.
Nice little tester for him to begin things, huh? I think he was hoping for a little bit more of a chip shot. Instead, they made him stretch it out a little bit, but he's got to feel great now that he put it through the pipes.
Offensive penalty has us back where we started as they come up on a first and 10. Now a play fake. Lance. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And got his man. Complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland.
For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible.
Well, in this league where coordinators worry so much about drawing up the right routes, blocking assignments, misdirections and stuff, they have these precise arrows and movements. Sometimes the best plays just come from the schoolyard where you look at your fastest guy and say, go long, go get it, big man.
And this will be a return from deep in the end zone. Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. On second and two, Lawrence. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. Touchdown!
In today's NFL, you know, we talk about quarterbacks and their speed and accuracy, but there's still something about a guy slinging one downfield.
And I'm telling you, nothing will light up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield, and you know everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open! What a connection there for the touchdown.
Extra point by McCann, up and good. And the lead is now 10-7. McCann's got it teed up. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Browns drive about to get started. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd-and-8 at the 27-yard line. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. On play action, Lance. A rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. He's picked off just shy of midfield. First interception thrown for him there, and that really not the best decision either.
Not at all. That's something he did not do in their victory last week. No interceptions in that game, but this defense, they're able to take advantage of an early mistake. Now let's see if they're going to turn it into points.
This starting field position, 1st and goal from 2 yards out. A snap to Lawrence as he taps this forward. And they will score. It's a Jacksonville touchdown. DJ Chark with his 2nd touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Jaguars are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by McCann, up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. McCann's got it teed up. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Browns drive about to get started. 4-4, their record through 8 games on the season. Would you say that this team has overperformed, underperformed, or are they kind of right where you thought that they would be?
Do you mind if I say yes, yes, and yes? Because ultimately to me, 4-4 is about where they should be, because we've seen weeks where they've been really, really good. They've looked terrific. Other weeks where we've wondered just how good is this team. They want to be consistent in their play. Not consistently inconsistent, which is what they've been thus far.
Here's 2nd and 10. Working from the gun, Lance. Going out wide, finds Chubb. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a 1st down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Off of play action, and here's Lance. Throwing right, and that's complete. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Play action, now it's Lance. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds.
If you run an out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Second down at 4. They fake the handoff. Now Lance. And that will be incomplete. They couldn't hook up on what's going to be the final play of this first quarter. After 1-17-7, the score on EA Sports. Our first update now comes from Atlanta. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. Again, they'll throw it with Lance. And he's going to have the hook up to Schwartz. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
I don't care how many times we see it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
The incomplete pass here now is 2nd and 10. Now Lance on the bootleg. And a quick throw here, that's complete. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's 3rd and 10.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Here comes the 8th play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on 3rd down. Lance going to throw. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there. And they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Lance now on 1st down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. A gain of 6 there on 1st. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15. A gain of 3.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That was a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
So they need 2 yards here on 3rd down. Remember, they're already 2 of 2 on 3rd down conversions on this drive. They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And Chubb fighting, but nowhere to go. He's going to be stopped short of that 1st down marker. A loss of 1 yard, and it brings up 4th.
It always helps when you get great run support from your safeties, and when you get one who can actually read the play and get upfield and shut it down before it gets going, it's exactly what you're looking for.
Lance to throw for it on fourth down.
Going right side here, and that's complete. And now this is going to be close. The defense says they stopped him, and they did. The Browns unable to move the chains on fourth down. And the Jaguars are going to take possession here on the turnover on downs. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence. Throw left side, going to be caught by Chenault. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And that'll lead here to a third down.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay gain.
Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
Well, things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick a down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
Now Lawrence on first down. And that's complete. ETN out of the backfield.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Again, it's Lawrence. He'll get this off to ETN, and he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Running out of the gun with ETN. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41.
And not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Here's Lawrence to throw. Able to complete this to Chenault.
And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns' 30.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
Throwing now, Lawrence on first down.
That's going to be caught. It's Chenault. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10, marking down at the 9.
I can't help but chuckle a little bit, because at this point, it can't be a surprise to anyone in the building who's going to get the ball. They just keep feeding him over and over, and he just keeps on delivering.
And they'll run with ETN.
And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. On second and goal, Lawrence. Oh, that'll be incomplete. Oh, he took a shot as he let that go.
And it's going to bring up a third down.
Well, to me, there was no question about the intent there, and I think he was a little fortunate that the penalty flag didn't come out for grounding. But he'll get away with it and get another shot on third down.
This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? Lawrence. Got his name. It's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. Hayden Hurst, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jaguars are able to widen their lead. Extra point by McCann, up and good. That'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. McCann's got it teed up. Drive about to get started, and they've got less than 30 seconds to go here, so not a lot of time to work with. Lance now on first down. Got a man, and he hits him in stride, and he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
On second and inches, Lance. He'll get this to Chubb out of the backfield. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. From midfield, here's Lance. Gonna throw right side here, complete. The Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. And just a yard to go here on second down. Lance looks to throw again. He's going to go for a big play downfield. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Asante Samuel Jr. And the Jaguars are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
That's another Oski, because that's the word we use when we intercept a pass. Oski tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week he got the Oski, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we now go downstate to Orlando and check in with Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Browns going to see the football first, but they trail here as we resume play on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. And you have to think, Charles, down three scores already, they need to play an almost perfect second half to have a solid chance.
And that absolutely starts with finding some way to put together a touchdown drive here. They need to be smart, fast, efficient, get the ball into the end zone, and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game.
And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Shotgun now for Lance. Escaping the pressure right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
And Lance will try again on second down. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Again, it's Lance. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Now a play fake. Lance. Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack. Caleb on chase on in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Throwing now is Lance. He's going to sling this deep downfield, and that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Well, the passing windows are just not there, and that's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
And whistle blown, a timeout here is taken, and it's taken by the kicking team. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth.
And they'll go for it. Lance.
And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And the Jags take over in terrific field position. On first and 10, it's Lawrence. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And now this is intercepted. My goodness.
Picked up by Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoa.
And the Browns are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line.
Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores. But, yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
Yeah.
The Browns drive about to get started. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on four, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold up.
But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do.
Off of play action, here's Lance.
And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Here's a quick throw out wide by Lance, complete.
And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. On second and 11 now. Lance eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And that's caught inside the 35. A big connection on that one, 33 yards. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10, just outside the 30.
They fake the handoff, now Lance.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Here's Lance to throw it. Going out wide, finds Chubb.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because they're built.
And he takes this one in for a Browns score. Nick Chubb. His 11th touchdown of the year.
And the Browns are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the third.
Extra point by Koo, up and good. And the lead is trimmed down to 10.
Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off.
And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose.
And this will be brought out from...
Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Flush to his right.
And Lawrence going to smartly hit the deck here as he is able to pick up the first down in the process.
Last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
That catch good for only a couple.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it can turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. but they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. From the 40 now on second down, Lawrence escaping the pressure right. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third. Here's a give to Etienne. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing, slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
On first down, Lawrence uncorks one for Davis. This is caught inside the 15. And he takes this way down deep into Cleveland territory. It's a big play for the Jaguars. From the shotgun, Lawrence flushed out right. And he takes this down to about the 2 before going out of bounds. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down. A snap to Lawrence as he taps this forward. And they will score. It's a Jacksonville touchdown. DJ Chark with his third touchdown of the ball game, number 12 on the season. And the Jaguars look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Extra point by McCann, up and good. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. McCann's got it teed up. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. On play action, Lance, nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage, but I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. Lance now to throw. Throw left side. There's Schwartz with it. The reception good for 7. It's third down. Play action. Now it's Lance. And that is incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He's going to look deep down the field. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And they do finally get him, but he takes it to the 25.
And a really unbelievable play there on fourth and long. He's got Njoku, his big tight end. And he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short. Lance looking to throw it. And he's wrapped up. Taken down. Back at the 25. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. To throw, it's Lance. Yeah, that one's going to be knocked away and incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Lance to throw for it on fourth down. He's got his tight end, David Njoku. And down inside the 15 he goes. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he's going to be intercepted a third time.
Picked off by Asante Samuel Jr. And the Jags are going to have the football here at their own 18-yard line. And that pretty much has been the storyline, Charles. This defense, they seem to be one step ahead from the start of the game until now.
And you identified it perfectly, and we can see the frustration that's settling in now. And it's probably been there for a long time. But now it's evident because you can see it in their faces, you can see it in their body language, maybe even a little bit in that play call that ended up maybe closing them out.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And it's starting to look like that three-game losing streak is going to be a thing of the past here. Coming up first and 10 in the fourth quarter. Nowhere to go here. And the most curious way there to burn some clock. That was wild. And at the end of all that, it winds up a safety. All right, Charles, help me out here. Fourth quarter, you've got the lead, and you run backwards into the end zone. You're just trying to do too much.
I almost don't have words for it. But you know, every coach that we talk to talks about running backs or people running the football, running north-south, getting upfield. He went way in the opposite direction, and that's going to cost his team.
Yeah, it cost him big time. Still leading, but it costs him. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. Here's Lance. And he will find his man Schwartz. That's complete. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agree. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
On first and 10, here's Lance. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
And now the focus is really clear. They need to get that first down and either get out of bounds or maybe use one of those timeouts.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From midfield, here's Lance. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off around the 37. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And they will finally bring this run back to an end, but not before he's down inside the 5-yard line at the 4. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
Look at me, Zipper!
That one looks like he'll throw here. It's complete on the bubble screen. That's Davis. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. A snap to Lawrence as he taps this forward. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Off the play fake. Here's Lawrence. Slap. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. And they're going to go for this thing. They're not going to leave anything to chance. They're going to roll the dice on fourth and goal. And they'll try and throw for it with Lawrence. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Greg Newsom. And the Browns are right back in this football game. Now with that interception, you feel like we got a ball game again. Remember, 2-score contest and still time left here in the fourth.
And in the old days, not too long gone either, throwing the ball here would have been an absolute no-no. But the way the game's played now, throwing it makes sense. You just have to be careful when you put it in the air.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And this will be caught at the 30. And a little bit of a consolation prize there. He's into the end zone. Won't win him the game, but they do get the score with all zeros showing.
But some fantasy players are really happy with that score.
Doesn't affect the outcome, but hey, nice job there to put it in the end zone for the final play.
Could it affect other things? Sometimes these types of scores are ones that we don't consider big at the time. Then later on we find out maybe that was a tiebreaker.
Yeah.
Or, of course, in the fantasy football world, these points mean a lot.
A lot there. One final try now for Lance. And that's caught for the additional 2 points. It'll only matter to the final scoreline, and that is the final act of this game. Well, at least at the very end, there's something to take away. They lost the game, but got in the end zone, got a 2-point conversion as well. I don't know, though. In the end, you still lost the football game.
You still lost the game, but maybe they were just capitalizing on the flurry at the end, right? You scored the touchdown, keep the momentum going, go for 2. Maybe they're working on something for down the road. As you said, it doesn't matter. You lose the game, but you finish with a touchdown and a successful 2-point conversion.
Some sort of a building block.
Yeah, something.
So for Jacksonville, they're back to .500 as they move to 4-4 on the year. And they'll get another home date next week as the Saints will come to town. Meanwhile, for Cleveland, they are barely afloat as they fall to 4-5. And they'll try to rebound next week as they head to Glendale to take on the Cardinals.
Crystal. Look, I played the game, I missed a shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance, for not, my not, my not. For Lexin, I fell out and cut the check, my not, my not. For life, I said, but I'm not. Born in the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I'm chopping, I'm chopping. Tell me the plot, because it ain't no stopping a run. Popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in the lands. I'm gonna all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand. The colors are mixing again. Grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my guts. The world is us, so what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up? My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut. Well, yeah. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Do what I do and I say what I want. Well, yeah, mommy, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack on my jacket at Grammy. We see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad city. You see the duality. Who trying to?
I shall come forth as pure gold. Have you been tried in the fire? Have you been tried in the fire? Well, tell me. Did you come through as pure gold?
You kick it like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. I went and got my digits up.
Listen.
Your favorite, bruh.
Listen.
You don't want no trouble, cuh. The 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's where rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip a in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red dog has caught me slipping with the willing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend on me. Chalked it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a, but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart he find forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him it was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I be and check out how I tend to mine. I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt or injure mine. He have your woman, and that's my dinner time. I keep my eyes on glory till the devil get behind. Now bear in mind the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a mind and have you salty as a bacon rind. I'm trying to mastermind how to help out humankind. I'm open mind, but I do not walk with none aligned. My state of mind is to keep a peaceful peace of mind. I'm like Malcolm with my peace at the Venetian blinds. I'm trying to manifest some things in my subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams in my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, swing the mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Making industry music, they want me to count to y'all, but ain't gon' count to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talk his body, wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my YG stop, he don't like to pass the ball. That chicken, he talking big hit, I was kicking in houses for it. That's two different tickets, right? Oh yeah, they loud, boy, them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be counting, boy, them labels scouting, boy, they talking M's only. Please don't test me like on that boy Jenny. It ain't talking games. It's like everything look cut them drop. They going.